A tremendous victory? I can't imagine he ever thought of it that way. I think 2 years in hell may have been more accurate. They never again set foot in California. By the time they got back to Chicago, he was broke with no prospects.
Welcome home, Dee.
He tried to pick up where he left off, but in truth, the boys downtown didn't care to know him. And his old labor friends would never again seek him out. At first, he made his living speaking and writing, like he'd always talked about. But the law was still in his blood. So, at a time when most of his cronies were retiring, my father had to start over.
Hey, is everyone asleep?
Everyone except Mary. She won't stop talking about her poppy. So I guess things are starting to pick up.
The body's still warm. People still have a perverse need to pay someone to hear things they don't want to hear. It's good to see you, Paul. It's been too long.
I wish you'd let us come out to California.
I know. Your letters meant a great deal to Ruby and me, but I just wasn't up to having company.
Listen, Dad, Lillian and I have been talking, and we'd like to invite you out to Colorado, you and Ruby.
Paul, this is no time for me to take up skiing.
No. I mean to live. You'd have the family around, and we're getting along well enough to help
now,
you.
And what would I do out there? Go into real estate? No. Paul, thanks for the thought, but I'll rest when they bury me. I've still got things to do in this life. And one of them is finish this puzzle.
I guess I underestimated him. I don't know if I could have stayed in the game the way he did. He once explained it to me this way. A pessimist, a true pessimist like myself, he said, knows that life is futile and that his fellow men are cruel, so he expects very little and is seldom disappointed.
Mrs. Darrow?
Yes, that's right. Have you any idea what time it is?
Yes, I do. I'm sorry to disturb you, but I must see your husband.
Well, he's in bed asleep. You can see him tomorrow morning.
Mrs. Darrow, I can't wait until tomorrow. My name is Jacob Loeb.
Gentlemen, even the rich have rights.
Well, boys, you've got the whole city and half of America calling for your heads.
Well, we want to do something that people would remember forever. The perfect crime.
It was supposed to be perfect.
Hey, it was your glasses they found in the culvert.
Yeah, well, if you hadn't kept hanging around the investigation like some hotshot reporter...
Boys! Please, Mr. Darrow is taking his valuable time.
Isn't that what we pay him for, Uncle Jacob?
Well, I haven't at all consented to take this case, Richard.
Well, I hope you do, Mr. Darrow.
You boys say that you had this murder planned for a long time, is that right?
Well, yes and no.
It was gonna be like surgery, better than Jack the Ripper.
It was supposed to be a girl. It was his idea for it to be a boy.
How'd you come to pick Bobby Franks?
He was my cousin. It was easy to get him in the car. Babe hit the gas.
Babe?
Babe. isn't my nickname.
Babe hit the gas and I bashed him with the chisel. Or maybe I was driving and Babe, I forget.
So he was already dead when you called his parents for the ransom?
That's right.
So kidnapping was part of the plan all along, kidnapping and then murder?
Not necessarily in that order.
Richard.
Well, boys, between the evidence and your confessions, I'd say the state's attorney's got two good chances to hang you. Once for murder, and if that doesn't work, he'll go after you for the kidnapping. And I'd say he's got two damn good cases. Have a seat. Well, you boys look fine. How are you holding up?
My brain must be the size of a pea. You sent us so many head shrinkers.
I don't know. I kind of found it fascinating.
Yeah, sure. It was fun. Telling each one a different story, whatever came into my head.
So, when do we make our grand entrance?
Well, Nathan, I wanted to talk to you boys before we go in. I know we've spent weeks acting like it, but we're not going to plead insanity.
What?
There is no way in the world that we will be able to convince a jury of 12 people that two very bright, very well-educated, and very privileged young boys couldn't tell right from wrong. So we're going to plead guilty to all the charges all at once and stand before one man, the judge, and convince him to save your lives.
You have one judge in the rest of the world.
Well, that's, hell of a time to tell us.
I apologize for springing this on you, but surprise was crucial. We couldn't let the prosecutor get a chance at separating the murder and kidnapping charges and get two tries at hanging you. I couldn't tell you before this for fear that someone else might hear about it. I'm sorry to have to do it this way.
So you're it, huh? Well, I hope this guy likes the way you play with your suspenders. Or we're meat on a hook.
Do I have your permission? Therefore, Your Honor, we bring our case before you and you alone and put their fate in none but your hands. We will offer our testimony and evidence not to determine their innocence, but for mitigation of punishment.
Your Honor, in the name of the fathers, mothers, and children of the state of Illinois, we will present our evidence and demand the maximum punishment that the law allows for these cruel and vicious murderers. The death penalty.
Mrs. Franks, these clothes were discovered in the car rented by Richard Loeb and Nathan Leopold. Are they familiar to you?
Bobby's. They were Bobby's.
Beside the massive head wounds, hydrochloric acid was poured on the boy's face, stomach, and genitals. His rectum was also dilated.
Indicating what, Dr. Springer?
Rectal penetration.
Your witness.
Dr. Springer, does this last finding necessarily indicate sexual molestation?
No, sir.
Was there any evidence of sexual molestation?
No, sir.
Thank you, Doctor. I miss having you in courtroom.
I know. Those boys make my skin crawl. I'm sorry. How much longer will you be at this?
Until I can figure out what all these psychiatrists are talking about, which could take years. Don't wait up.
All right. Oh, I wish the police would chase them away.
Not me. They give me inspiration.
Dickie's parents were cold. He constantly strove for attention he could not get. So he escaped into dime detective novels. Over time, he evolved a fantasy of committing the perfect crime.
What did you find in your analysis of Nathan Leopold, Dr. White?
Babe is an extremely gifted young man. But two crucial events occurred when he was 9 years old. His mother, to whom he was especially close, died. And then his father gave him over to the care of a nanny who had him play games with her of a sexual nature. She made him a kind of slave.
In Nathan's fantasy world, Richard is the Dream King. They made a pact where Nathan would participate in any crimes Richard wanted him to, as long as Nathan could insert his penis between Richard's legs. Nathan has a great disdain for everybody but Richard. I think his love is so great, he'd rationalize anything to keep that affection. Even murder.
He was a good boy. And a promising boy. And would have made a bright and good man. Instead, Bobby Franks was beaten and murdered. It's an insult for these two to come before you and ask for mercy. Mercy? For cold-blooded, depraved killer? I don't care about their mitigating circumstances, their nannies, and their fantasies. I care about my own life and the life of this society. Yes, let's be merciful. Ourselves. Let us send a clear and certain message to any others who might be tempted to vent their evil upon us and upon our children. Hang them, Your Honor. Be as merciful to them as they were to Bobby Frank.
Thought I'd join you today, if you don't mind.
It's pretty rough out there today, Rube. I don't know.
So I'm coming, Dee.